In this tutorial, I'll show you how to model a mace mesh. Let's import a reference image. I'll share the download link in the description below. R to rotate. G and X to move on the X axis. I'll lower the reference image's opacity a bit. Let's create a cylinder. S to scale, and S and Z to scale on the Z axis. Tab to go to edit mode. 3 to face select. Let's select the top face and move it down a bit. After selecting the bottom face, Ctrl B to bevel and mouse wheel up to add more segments. Let's select the bottom face once again, and proportionally move and scale it down like this. I'll create the ring mesh with a torus. Right-click to shade smooth. Shift-D to duplicate, and Z to bring it downward. Let's select the cylinder and Ctrl-3 to subdivide. In edit mode, Ctrl-R to add a loop cut. Let's select the top face and type I as in India to extrude it inward. Let's create a cube. I'll move the faces to match the reference image. Please remember to press Ctrl while moving the left face to snap to the grid. Ctrl R to add a loop cut. 1 to vertex select, and G and X to move on the X axis. S and Y to scale on the Y axis. Let's create an empty object and use it as an array anchor as usual. Ctrl A to reset all transforms. We could leave the top part like this, or bring the top face down and add a cone mesh. Let's add a cone. In edit mode, select the cone mesh's bottom face and S to scale. Let's auto-smooth the mesh. I'll add metallic materials for the meshes. Let's go to edit mode, and add a loop cut to divide the faces for the handle material. The bottom part needs a loop cut as well. Let's bring the lower vertices down a bit. Time to set up the render scene. Before rotating the mesh, we need to apply the array modifier. Select the main node, and press Ctrl, Shift, and T, together to add the PBR texture images. Let's activate displacement and bump for the wooden material. Let's turn off Use Nodes under Compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.